Hi folks, Canadian Prepper here, testing out my new three-axis gimbal. Actually, it's not new, I've had it for a couple months. So we've got a golden eagle overhead. That's a good omen. So I've been putting off making this video for about a few months anyways. I've actually made it a couple times and it just never got put on wax. But today, I think today's the day to finally put this out there because I've gained enough evidence, if you want to call it that, to make some pseudo conclusions with confidence about how YouTube works and, you know, things related to my channel's standing and whatnot. I'm going to quickly tell you how YouTube works if you're a content creator. First off, I don't like the word content. I just find it to be dry. I'm a content creator. No. You know, I'm a prepper, I'm a survivalist. I talk about prepping and survival. I don't make content. That just sounds so like you're doing it for the sake of doing it, which I've never done and I never will do. When the time comes that there's no more to say, I'll stop talking. Anyways, so for many months, my channel's been on the decline. Actually, first off, how YouTube works. So if you're starting a new channel, or if you already have a channel, the vast majority of your views that you get are not going to come from your subscribers. Contrary to popular belief, most of them come either from the suggested videos on the sidebar here, or from search. That's where the majority of your views come from. I would say between 70 to 80% of the views that you get come from those sources. So the whole idea is to, you know, convert those views into subscriptions. That's the end goal if you're into the task of making videos. I'm not going to say content creation. I'm going to try not to for the rest of this video, but sure enough, I probably will. Anyways, so yeah, it basically, without those suggested videos and without your videos coming up in search, your channel really has no chance of growing. I mean, if you think about it, that's the only way people who are not familiar with your stuff, notice how I didn't say content, can actually see it. So, okay, that said, now in the last 6 months, I've bit my tongue about this many times, but my channel has been in decline. I haven't said anything about it. And the reason why I haven't said anything about it, because in the past I've hit plateaus with the channel, and typically what happens is the channel will plateau for a while and then you'll get these bumps where you go up in views and go up in subscribers and it'll plateau again and you're constantly moving upwards. For the most part, if you're producing content of reason, oh, here I go again. If you're producing stuff, videos, information that's relatively high quality, your channel should be growing and it should be remaining relevant. Now mine has declined about 50% in terms of viewership, and I've lost almost 7,000 subscribers since starting this channel, which based on my research, I don't think is, they're all legitimate unsubs. I think a lot of that is some sort of YouTube glitch, because I get between 20 to 40 people unsubscribing every day. And they're all unsubscribing from the channels. Very few unsubscribe from videos. And I know all this because of YouTube's very detailed analytics that they provide. It's very detailed. You can pretty much, you know, dial it into to any analytic that you want. You can, you know, cross compare and all that stuff. So I know that people are not unsubscribing on videos. They're going to my channel and unsubscribing, which I just think is, you know, BS, because, you know, why would you go to the channel to unsubscribe when you could be watching a video to do it? I mean, that's, it would make sense that that's where you would unsubscribe. So, and I know that YouTube has a tendency to unsubscribe people to channels, and I've noticed that myself, that I've just been magically unsubscribed to a lot of channels that I enjoy, and then I have to resubscribe. So I'm not sure what's up with that, but I do know that I'm not having my videos suggested nearly as much as I once was. And so the traffic sources are primarily for my subscribers. Now this is troublesome to me because in the last year, my content production, my video production has almost doubled, like in terms of how many videos I put out a month. And the quality, as far as I can tell anyways, based on my, you know, biased subjective perspective, is still pretty darn good. In fact, I think it's better than I've ever done before. So the question is, you know, all things are pointing towards channel growth. The shares are up significantly. The likes are up. The comments are up. Every analytic pretty much across the board is up except views and except referrals from other traffic sources. So that means that my videos are not being promoted in the YouTube sidebar. So I leads me to wonder, well, what could possibly be, you know, causing this? And looking back at some of the videos I've made since this growth lull hit, or since this dip in views hit, I should say, because it's not a growth lull, it's a decline, drastic decline. I've produced a few controversial videos. You know, I talked about the chaos theory thing where, you know, it was an after the collapse installment where I pretty much went on about everything from transhumanism to, you know, why society fears preppers. I talked about, you know, my views about women's role in SHTF. I talked a bit about race. But with all of this, as many of you know, I keep a pretty level head and I'm fairly realistic and, you know, even keeled in my assessments of these things. I don't blindly support one view or the other. I'm not like a staunch left winger or right winger. I actually don't really buy into that whole political divide and conquer thing at all, which is part of the reason why I think that my channel has sort of hit a growth lull. Not only is there perhaps not as much of a demand for reasonable, rational thought in our society, I actually just think that somebody up top in YouTube executive land pushes a button and says, okay, this content is not conducive towards some master plan, perhaps. And that's getting pretty conspiratorial. That's one explanation that I'm willing to entertain. This still could all be a glitch. And, you know, I could be on the precipice of a huge growth boom. Who knows? But for a person like me who puts so much work into the channel, and I know some people are going to say, oh, you got 40,000 subscribers. What are you complaining about? Well, yeah, I mean, that's great. But, you know, when you have 2,000, 10,000 seems like a lot. When you have 10,000, 40,000 seems like a lot. I mean, growth is the nature of the economic paradigm that we live in right now. It's the nature of freedom and democracy and liberty and all that kind of good stuff, right? So, of course, I'm going to expect that the channel will continue to grow and not be in a decline. So, anyways, where am I going with all of this? So, yeah, it would appear to me as though that perhaps my content, there I go again, perhaps my videos are not conducive to the master plan. You know, and it's funny because if you're one of these channels who's like staunchly right-wing fundamentalist or even staunchly, you know, left-wing, anti-gun, whatever, you know, all of a sudden your channel gets lots of referrals. Or if you're entirely apolitical and you're completely universal and you don't mention politics, religion, you know, philosophy, anything, then you're okay too. It's almost as if you either have to be apathetic or a wingnut in order to get attention. If you look at the channel Jason A, who I periodically indulge in from time to time, not because I believe the subtext that's put forth there with respect to, you know, the whole Christian fundamentalist view of the end of the world as we know it and stuff like that, the apocalypse, but I do definitely think that there's, you know, some interesting news clips that he puts together But it's amazing how fast that channel grows, and no matter how many failed predictions and sensationalist titles the guy uses in his videos, if it's even a guy, I don't know if it's a, you know, a consortium of people who make those videos or what might be the case, but it doesn't matter how many failed predictions, how many sensationalist titles they use, the channel's constantly growing. You know, it gets all kinds of exposure. It's referred to in the suggested video feed often. I always see it in there, those videos. And the same thing on the left, you know, there's certain, it seems as though YouTube, like any sort of media, starts out very grassroots, very open source, you know, where everybody has an equal opportunity. And then progressively, as time goes on, YouTube plays favorites with different channels in every genre. And they do it on the basis of, I don't think it's strictly marketing, because if it was marketing, my channel would be growing at a very fast rate, because I know this based on my analytics and my watch time. Watch time is what YouTube cares about most. They don't care about views, they care about watch time. So much so that they make it hard for you to find your views in analytics. You can, not hard, but it's harder than watch time. They label it as watch time. That's the sort of de facto measurement tool that they use. So if you have a lot of watch time, that's more pertinent than views in terms of measuring how financially lucrative is to back your channel and put ads on it. So my average watch time is between 6 and 7 minutes. And my average watch time from suggested videos is over 5 minutes, which is very high for suggested videos. So there's no reason why, you know, my videos should not be appearing in that suggested news feed more often, because they're marketable, you know, from a strictly advertising standpoint, which is not why I do this. You know, I mean, I do this because I like to do it, because I'm passionate about it, but indeed everybody has to eat. And I can tell you right now that I don't make money off of this. I really don't. I don't think I've made a penny when I think about how much time I've invested and how much resources it takes. And, you know, I really don't make much at all. But that's fine. You know, I have hopes that someday I may have some sort of sustainable income off that. I just hope that that comes before my passion runs out, you know, for making videos. Anyways, so I have a very marketable channel, but it's not being marketed, which leads me to believe that YouTube plays favorites in each genre, and they want, you know, a handful of channels to sort of stand out in every genre as the main channels in that genre, and everything else is kind of just fed scraps. You know, some channels are elevated instantly, and I don't find the content to be that revolutionary or insightful. Even, like I said, if you're a wingnut or if you're entirely apathetic and universal, you'll get exposure. But if you're reasonable and you're rational and you're a Libra like me, you have the scales of justice by your side and you try to weigh the pros and cons of things and you like to think, then it appears that we are not economically viable. What's that movie with that guy? What's it called? Falling Down with, yeah. That's an awesome movie, by the way. There's this black guy who's talking to Michael Douglas, who's having the worst day of his life. And anyways, go see the movie. It's awesome. But he wasn't economically viable, and apparently neither am I. But that said, you know, this could just be a phase. And I've been reluctant to make this video because I don't want to come off as some sort of whiny baby, but I think that there's possibly other channels who are going through the same thing. In fact, I know there is. I know for a fact that there's a lot of great channels out there who aren't getting the exposure they deserve. And there's a lot of just mediocre channels who seem to get all the growth and all the exposure. And I'm not hating, you know, I wish success for everybody. I sincerely do wish that everybody who makes videos, who makes quality videos, gets the exposure they deserve. but it would seem that there's a lot of, I don't know if it's just, they call it algorithms, but you know, that seems like a great way to deflect any sort of criticism of, you know, the actual process that goes on in determining how videos get suggested, because they can just go back to say, oh, well, it's algorithms. Well, you know, all the stats are showing growth, but all my numbers are showing drastic decline. I mean, I'm struggling just to keep my head above water in terms of viewership, subscribers gained. Like I said, I have 20 to 40 people unsubscribing a day. I'm guessing at least half of those people don't even know they're unsubscribed. And I'm not talking about the massive YouTube purge that they do every 6 months. They did that a couple weeks ago where everybody, you know, every YouTube channel lost a bunch of subscribers. That's not what I'm talking about. PewDiePie lost 600,000. I lost a couple hundred. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about a daily occurrence of losing subscribers. So, you know, it is what it is. I guess I just figured in putting it out there, maybe that will get some attention. Maybe it'll get the wrong kind of attention. You know, maybe this is my penultimate video. Maybe this is gonna, you know, maybe this is shooting myself in the foot by doing a video like this. I don't know. But I haven't violated any YouTube terms, as far as I can tell, in making this video. And I've seen a lot of YouTube rants on big channels and they never get taken down. So I think I'm all right. So let me know what you guys think about this. If you had similar experiences, if you're a video maker, not a content creator. And even for you subscribers out there, let me know if you have any experiences being randomly unsubscribed from this channel or other channels. And I also want to request that if you do enjoy this channel and you can't make a donation, which is fine, I totally understand that, you can support the channel in numerous ways simply by commenting. You know, that boosts the analytics. Offering a like or dislike, even if you dislike the video, that's engagement too. You can click on the Amazon link below, and that I get a trickle of affiliate marketing through that. So if you're going to buy something anyways, if you buy it through that portal, I get a little bit of compensation for that. That helps out the cause a bit. Sharing the video helps on various forms of social media. You know, whatever you can do in that respect, it doesn't require money. You know, I'm certainly not going to start e-bagging or anything like that. But if you wanted to support this channel and you want to help me counteract this apparent suppression, it feels like suppression. It feels like I've hit some sort of glass ceiling, but I don't want to be prematurely indignant and playing the victim either, because I know that sometimes you just got to wait for your time to shine, right? And I'm not really looking to shine. I'm just looking for my just desserts. So let me know what you think, guys. Thanks for watching. Canadian Prepper out. Oh yeah, one more thing. The Apollo Tactical Bow Contest. I'm going to be drawing for that in the next couple days. And I have to say that, you know, I got a suspicious amount of entries on the last day of that contest. And they all were within... Actually, I had this happen a few times where I'll get several contest entries within the span of a short time. I pretty much know what's going on there. It doesn't take a rocket science to figure out that people are making multiple sock accounts and trying to get multiple entries in. So I just want to say, for such a significant prize like that, don't worry. I vet the participants really well and I make sure that everybody fulfills the contest criteria. I don't, like one guy suggested, just pick a friend to give it to or something stupid like that. Like, that's just preposterous to even, you know, accuse me of doing something like that. The person I want to get it is somebody who is a genuine survivalist prepper who, you know, concerns himself with matters that I discuss and perhaps could benefit from something like that. And of course, somebody who fulfilled the contest criteria. So It's totally random, but if I pull something that looks like BS, it goes back into the bin, or actually it just goes into the garbage and I pull another name. So I'm just being honest with that because I want to make sure that the person who wins that prize is somebody who is a bona fide survivalist prepper who watches this channel, who supports this genre on YouTube, and themselves is struggling to get more self-reliant. So once again, thanks for watching Canadian Prepper Out.
Check out the Canadian Preppers Network blog, an excellent resource for survivalists and preppers.